was new. The gods defeated the Titans. As the last Titan fell, he swore a curse on the gods. And when his blood struck the sea, the giants were born.
The rumors are true. An army from the east descends upon us. This enemy is unlike anything we've ever seen before.
By the gods.
You must find the giant remains. It is the source of the demon's power. Burn the remains and the demons will fall.
What's your name?
Heron.
Join us.
If what she says is true, we should go.
You don't understand. It'll be our death.
What are you talking about?
You're no bastard. You're the son of Zeus.
Convert or die.
The fate of the world rests in your hands.
Zeus, and all that I've promised you will...
Aloha! This is Trinidad, the island man, your island man, coming to you live once again from beautiful Hawaii here on the island of Oahu, bringing you, yes you, the best movie reviews on the entire island of Oahu. And yes, this is Trinidad, the island man, your island man. And, well, unfortunately today I'm not bringing you a movie review as much as a television show review on Netflix. A show that dropped the 27th of October over the weekend called Blood of Zeus. Now, this is an animated Netflix original series. 8 episodes, about 25 minutes apiece. And let me just say this. Remember our rating scale? Shock a thumbs up. It's good to see. I recommend it. Shock a thumbs down. It's junk. I don't recommend it. Don't watch it. And for the Amazon original animated series, season 1, 8 episodes of Blood of Zeus, it is a shock a thumbs up. Now, let me just get into this a little bit. This is by Powerhouse Animated Studios. From Netflix, for Netflix. Basically the same studios, Powerhouse Studios Animations is also the studio that brought you the Castlevania season 1 and 2. But let me just say this, if you enjoyed Castlevania seasons 1 and 2, then you will enjoy Blood of Zeus. If you did not enjoy Castlevania seasons 1 and 2, then you'll probably enjoy Blood of Zeus because it is that much better. You know, I only watched season 1 of Castlevania. I didn't care for season 2. And season 1 kind of rubbed me the wrong way. Too much religious mumbo-jumbo in it. Not enough, you know, too much talking, not enough action and fighting, honestly, for what you're supposed to be battling Dracula, you know, along with his demon or monster, vampire-ish creatures overall. It just seemed too slow in season 1, finally barely getting down to it in season 2. And then I said, well, you know, or in season 3, you know, at the end of season 1, and then... Or was it 3 seasons? I might have watched 1 and 2. Wherever they beat Dracula. Yeah, I think it was season 1 and 2. Or did they split up the season? Ah, I can't remember. Either way, whatever came after where they beat Dracula and it went into something new, I didn't watch that one. But the animation, you know, the monsters looked weird. All like deformed. You know, who knows what demons are supposed to look like, right? So, you know, that, you know, you can give it a pass on that, but it was just too much to take. Here in Blood of Zeus, which is basically a new telling of some of the basic stories of Greek mythology about Zeus and the gods of Olympus, Hera, Apollo, Hermes, etc., along with some of the demigods, if not Hercules and Perseus, then this new one, this new son of Zeus and son of a mortal, as Zeus was known to, you know, spread his seed around a lot, giving, you know, human mothers, you know, sons and daughters of demigods, which is nothing new. So we have a new hero called Heron. And now Heron is played by Derek Phillips, voiced by Derek Phillips. And he has a brother, a half-brother named Seraphin, played by Alexis Tofexis, who, and both of those guys voice these characters wonderfully. The main heroine is Alexa, played by Jessica Henswick. Zeus himself is played by Jason O'Mara, and Claudia Kristen plays Hera, wife of Zeus. If you know anything about Greek mythology, vain to many of the bastard sons of Zeus, such as Hercules and even Perseus, where Hera's kind of, you know, she doesn't like Zeus fooling around. He would like, and she would want nothing better than to destroy all of his illegitimate offsprings. If you've seen like Hercules, the Legendary Journeys, then you know that that whole television show basically back in the 90s was set with Hercules against the forces of Hera, being the son of Zeus. You know, Hera kills Hercules' family and his wife, and he is forever attempting to get revenge on Hera, at least up until the last few seasons where the plot kind of changes. But that's pretty much the gist of it. And this is pretty much the gist of Blood of Zeus, where we see that these two brothers are separated by birth, you know, and different fates fall upon them. This story is filled throughout the entire 8 seasons, not only with action, bloodshed, but also with a twist of pathos. That is what Greek mythology, and pretty much packed with Greek mythology, packed with pathos, which Greek mythology is well known all about. So you should definitely go ahead and check that out. You know, if you're a fan of Greek mythology, if you enjoyed like classic movies from the 80s, like Clash of the Titans, then this is definitely up your alley. You know, and Netflix does a far better job in this telling of this story of this Greek mythology tale of, you know, the Greek myths of heroes and of gods and demons, the titans, the giants come back to attempt to destroy Olympus, to destroy the Greek gods, and to take back over the earth and destroy all of humanity, much before the Zeus and the Greek gods turned on the titans and basically made the earth for humans to inhabit. So the giants or the titans, giants which they're referred to in this show, wish to reclaim the earth and destroy all the humans, taking it back to when they once ruled, when it was all theirs alone. Now this is created by Charlie Parla Pandies and Visas. Parla Pandies, who had worked on such films as like Immortals, just to name one of their other films. So they have kind of a common experience with Greek mythology and the tales of ancient Greek and Rome. And, you know, and so you can definitely feel that this is a well-grounded, well-versed show all through the entire 8 episodes, recreating this myth and pretty much following in the footsteps of the classic Clash of the Titans 80s show. Very much more so done better than, what was it, the Clash of the Titans back from the 90s, and then the Wrath of the Titans sequel that had like Liam Neeson as Zeus. That was pretty much junk, with just a lot of CGI craziness in it. And the story was pathetic. You'd be better off just watching that classic 80s Clash of the Titans again. That has the full story, a much better story, and even more grounded special effects, being stop motion. And in Blood of Zeus, this is what is pretty much taken past that to a whole brand new level. We find out that Heron's brother, Seraphin, has had a rough life just as Heron. So we see they're both twins, and they are two sides of a different coin, or two sides of the same coin, both having hard experiences, but both taking divergent paths. One maybe, better off, in better position, since he has his mother, than perhaps the other brother. But one becomes a demon, one is the son of a god, and thus the two ultimately, as in much Greek pathos, must come to combat and fight one another, against the backdrop of the gods fighting the Titans, or these giants seeking to reclaim the earth, being kind of transformed into a demon. Seraphin aligns himself with the Titans and the giants, seeking more power, seeking to rule, seeking revenge for what was done to him as a child, for all the opportunities that he did not have. And Heron, seeking, to avenge the death of his mother, to come to terms and accept who he is, what he is as a demigod, the son of Zeus, and help, take a position alongside him and the gods to save humanity as his mother would want, but still attempting to reach out to sway his brother back to the light side and away from the darkness before it ultimately consumes him completely. Now, like I said, this is 8 episodes, a fantastic amount of action, well put together story through each of the 8, 25, one season episodes. At the end, it is left up to a possible sequel. You could see how they could do it. Very much as they did Castlevania, they could continue on with these heroes, perhaps the son of these heroes in this story, maybe a new age of the gods. One can't say. I don't believe there's any news as of yet from Netflix about wanting to do a second season, but at the end they do leave it very well open for another chapter. If not a continuation of this same story, then a brand new chapter in the new world that is created from the conclusion of these 8 episodes in season 1. So again, it is a strong shock of thumbs up. I really did enjoy it. I finished it in just 2 days. Like I said, there's only 8 episodes, 25 minutes apiece. So, in a couple hours, you're through the first half, and then 2 more hours, you're done with the second half, sets of 4, if you're going to watch it like that. Maybe a little too bloody for small children, definitely for young, mature audiences, just because of the bloodshed. There is a lot of blood from demons and humans, as there's a lot of fighting. Just as there was in those Clash of the Titan movies, things from Sinbad, etc. So maybe not particular for small children, but you know, definitely an older child, adolescents, could probably stomach this along with you, watching them watch it to explain anything, especially if maybe you've got them grounded in some traditional Greek myths as well. If they've enjoyed shows like Hercules on television, you know, this is definitely a step above and beyond that of, you know, the classic Disney films, which, you know, shy away from all the bloodshed. So it is darker in that respect, but for the next evolution, the next stage of, you know, watching, you know, maturity, you know, you might consider your teenage child, you know, 12, 14 years old, to go ahead and watch this show and get more grounded in the philosophies of ancient Greece and, you know, the mythology of the Greek pantheon of heroes and basically what they had done. You know, if, you know, you've shown your child Clash of the Titans, that classic 80s movie, and they've enjoyed it, then there's probably nothing to fear too much with watching this Netflix series. But you'll have to be the judge of that. All I can say is that you should watch it. It is a good shock a thumbs up show. Well done to Netflix. And I enjoy the possibility of watching a second season of this far more than I did for Castlevania. That's for sure. All right, thank you so much. This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, giving Blood of Zeus, the 8-episode first season on Netflix, a shock a thumbs up. If you haven't watched it, go ahead and check it out. You know, it's only a few hours of watching, and then you're done with it. You know, and see how it feels. See how you like it. Again, it is animation, but it's well-done animation, far superior to what the, you know, DC animated studios are putting out nowadays, and far better than the Castlevania stuff. You know, people are drawn a little bit more anatomically correct, proportional wise. Even the demons, which are shaped from humans, you know, which are transformed humans, they're not too outlandishly drawn. Now when you get towards the Titans themselves, the giants, then you get a little bit more wild variety in the creature concept level mythology had shown in the past. So again, shock a thumbs up for Blood of Zeus. Go ahead and check it out when you can, however you can. They're on Netflix. If you're a subscriber already, you're not losing anything, and you're looking for something to watch, check it out. All right, thank you so much. This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, here in Hawaii, saying aloha and mahalo.